In the previous video, we started talking about environment automation. And we also talked about which are the stages of environment provisioning, configuration, and deployment that we could automate. We also talked about cloud. Now, when you talk about automating environments, also deployments, what you need to understand is the concept of writing infrastructure as a code. And that ability to write or describe the state of your infrastructure as a code is extremely important, and that sets apart from the previous generation of tools and today's generation of tools that we use for automation. Now, we've been relying on documentation as well as the procedural codes such as scripts, or we just go through, you know, write them documentation and do things manually when you talk about provisioning infrastructure, or it could be configuring things or also deployment, right? Now that changes with this, because instead of following a procedure, following a documentation, you start describing things which becomes a self-documentation itself. That code that we write to describe, let's say, how do we provision things or how do we configure things, becomes a self-documentation, and that is treated as a code. And since it is a code, you can actually create or revision control it. You can create consistent environments based on the revision control system and configure things at scale with that. And things become repeatable. It becomes flexible. It becomes automatable, because you know a lot of tools use data formats such as YAML and JSON, and that's what we start using with some of these automation tools. And since we're treating it as an application code, you can start using the best practices that developers have been following for years, such as test-driven development, using better editors and refactoring tools. You can actually revision control your infrastructure state, which was not possible earlier, and you can recreate that complete state of the infrastructure out of a code base and some compute resources that you may need. Now, where does it apply is you may want to provision things on VMs or cloud, or later on you want to do the configurations or deployment. All of that can be defined using infrastructure as a code tools. Now, what are the tools applicable here? Let's have a look at that. When it comes to provisioning, if it is a cloud provisioning, which generally is based on the APIs, you have either cloud-specific tools. For example, AWS has Cloud Formation, OpenStack has Heat, or you can also have a cloud-agnostic tool such as Terraform. Terraform allows you to, it's a very popular tool today, and it allows you to create multi-code for multi-cloud provisioning. It is cloud-agnostic. It works with AWS, it works with OpenStack, Azure, Google Cloud, or any other cloud, generic cloud that you may need. You can write the same specification or using the same language, and underneath that it has some libraries which talks to each of that cloud and gets things done. So all you have to do is define what you want in terms of the state of your infrastructure, and it gets translated into the actual cloud provisioning. You also have a lot of applications, let's say Python, which supports APIs. Let's say Python has a Boto library which lets you connect with AWS, so you can also use or leverage those tools to provision things on cloud. When it comes to VMs provisioning, the best tool to use there is called as Vagrant. And Vagrant, again, just like Terraform, it's a multi hypervisor provisioner, so it works with a local hypervisor such as VirtualBox or VMware, or it can connect to even a cloud provider such as AWS and get your VMs provision. Now, where Vagrant is used mostly is local virtual machine provisioning. It simplifies the things of creating VMs, either one VM or multiple VMs there. Now, another tool here which is interesting and that's quite versatile is Ansible, and it not only allows you to create or provision servers on the cloud, it also lets you do the configuration management that we talk about next. Now, configuration management is what comes after you have provisioned the server. Let's say you have created a cloud server or a VM and you want to go and configure it in a consistent way. You can use one tool. That's where you define the state of your infrastructure. I'm going to show an example of that. And that works on not only multiple different clouds, also multiple environments. So you can create consistent configuration across your environments across your data center. Maybe you have infrastructure in your data center and cloud. You can consistently configure that using the same code out of a code repository. And this is an example of a configuration management tool using a declarative syntax. This is an example of a Puppet code. But if you look at Chef or Ansible or a lot of other infrastructure provisioning tools, it follows a similar approach. And what is different from the previous approach, let's say script here, is we don't care about how the user is. This is an example of creating a user and we're just declaring what we want. We don't care about how the user is created, on which system, which platform, what is the process, what is the current state. All of that is completely managed by the underlying tool, that is, let's say Chef or Puppet or Ansible. And what do we care about is what do we want. We just define that I want a user whose name is X, whose properties are Y, and I want it in a state Z, and that's all I care about. And it, you know, that simplifies the way you manage your infrastructure as well as do the configuration or manage the entities in general. And a couple of tools that you should definitely know about is, one is Vagrant for provisioning local infrastructure, development infrastructure, or there is Docker. Docker is the tool which is the most popular today. At the time of recording these videos, Docker has gained a lot of significance in its influencing the way we are building, shipping, and delivering the software. So if you have not heard of Docker, or if you have not started using Docker, definitely start using this. This is the one tool which is going to change the way we are delivering the software completely. So it's important to understand and use, start using it, or start at least learning about this particular tool. In this video, we talked about some of the infrastructure as a code tools and the concept related to that. In the next one, we are going to start talking about how do defects influence things, and how do we mitigate or reduce the number of defects in your system.